Now for more on Typhoon Muifa, we are joined by Daryl Snow from the China Meteorological Administration. Hi. Daryl, when and where will Muifa make landfall and what will be the immediate impact?
Well, it's currently around 460 kilometers southeast of Zhejiang Province, Zhoushan there, and it's traveling at around 15 kilometers per hour. Still extremely strong. It was downgraded to a Category 1 typhoon, having previously been Category 5. Still very strong, though. Wind speeds near the center around 45 meters per second. That's extremely powerful hurricane force winds. Now, at some point from the early hours tonight into tomorrow afternoon, there's a chance it could make landfall anywhere between Zhejiang and Jiangsu provinces. Otherwise, it may just skirt along the coast of China up towards the Shandong Peninsula. It may even curl back towards the Korean Peninsula. These things are hard to predict. We'll be keeping an eye on that. What we do know, of course, is that it's already brought more than 200 millimeters of rain to Japan's southern islands around Okinawa. Very strong winds as well. And its main impact over the next few days is going to be along China's east coast.
Right, and Daryl, how are things going to develop in the coming days? Will it slowly die down or become more intense?
Well, we're already seeing rain start to pick up along China's eastern coast there around northern Zhejiang, Shanghai up into Jiangsu. Some very strong winds as well. In fact, places like Ningbo, a city in eastern Zhejiang, set for extremely torrential rain today with wind speeds probably around gale force 9. So that's, say, 80 kilometers per hour, extremely strong winds. And in fact, the rain may intensify overnight tonight into tomorrow as the storm continues to approach. Tomorrow, those torrential downpours will be seen from northern Zhejiang up through Jiangsu all the way up to the Shandong Peninsula. So extremely heavy rain tomorrow, certainly for places like Nanjing, Hangzhou, Shanghai, Suzhou, also Qingdao. And then on Monday, the storm will generally be focused further north up around the Yellow Sea there. So rain should rapidly die down around Shanghai, probably just some light showers around there on Monday, but instead still quite torrential rain up in Qingdao, Tianjin, Dalian, Weihai, places like that. Strong winds too as well, obviously. Maybe also some heavy rain around Beijing, some moderate breeze around Beijing and Tianjin, but places like Qingdao, Dalian still set for at least gale force 7 winds, around 50 kilometers per hour. Then heading on into Tuesday, the storm will still be pretty fierce, but still focusing further northeast into northeastern China. So again, rain should rapidly die down further south. Shandong Peninsula there set for just light showers on the whole, but still quite heavy showers up around eastern Inner Mongolia, Heilongjiang, western Jilin, Liaoning, and northern Hebei around there. So in summary then, really tomorrow the places bearing the brunt of this storm are going to be cities like Shanghai, Nanjing, Hangzhou. Torrential rain, very strong winds as well. We can certainly expect some travel problems, flight delays, cancellations, and problems with the trains and so on.
Thank you very much. That was Daryl Snow from the China Meteorological Administration.